In this video, I am going to discuss another very important chapter, Chemistry Everyday Life, for CET as well as NEET level exam. It is also very important. Here, in this video, I am going to discuss some synopsis points related to the chapter Chemistry in Everyday Life. In that, my first point, importance of chemistry. Is there any importance of chemistry in your day-to-day life? Yes. Without chemistry, there is no life. Because whatever you see, whatever you do, it involves chemistry. Most of our body work also contains our chemistry. Based on chemistry, it works. And already you know, in presence of agricultural field like fertilizers, next in presence of medical field like drugs, next cosmetics, and soaps, detergents, polymers, dyes, etc. They have very important role in our today life. Because of this point, we say, without chemistry, there is no life. My next point, drugs and its classification. What are drugs? Drugs are the single chemical substance or group of chemical substance which are used to prevent the diseases. And in theory classes you already studied about its classification. Our drugs are classified on the basis of 4 points. What are those 4 points? First one, based on the pharmacological effect. Next, second one, based on drug action. Next, based on chemical structures. Another one, molecular targets. Okay, based on these points, drugs are classified. In that, pharmacological effects, based on pharmacological effects, classification is very useful for the medical field, is that doctors. Next, based on the effect, based on the molecular effects or drug action, this classification is very helpful to the chemists. Remember this point. And another one very important concept is that drug receptor theory. Very important, see here. This drug receptor theory is explained by 2 scientists. One is Langley and his friend Eldridge. This drug receptor theory is usually explains the behavior of drug. Here, the drug is interact with the receptor and works. Here, the drug is interact with the receptor in a reversible manner and changes the states of receptor. The binding between this drug and receptor, it introduces or shows the relationship between the drug and receptor is that this theory, which one? Drug receptor theory. Binding between drug and receptor, it describes the relationship between the drug and the receptor. In this theory, there are 2 concepts is very used. What are those? They are agonist and antagonist drugs. Remember these 2 points, these are very useful for your CET level examination questions. In that first one, agonist. What are these agonist drugs? Remember, these are the drugs which bind with the receptor and activate receptor. Remember, agonist drugs are the drugs which are interact with the receptor and activate the receptor. And what are antagonist drugs? These are also drugs which are interact with the receptor and prevent the functions of that receptor. Remember these two points. These are also appear in presence of drug receptor theory. Next, very important, different type of drugs are observed. In that, my first point, antibiotics. What are antibiotics? Antibiotics. What are antibiotics? These are the chemical substances which are usually invented from living cells and which prevent the growth of microorganisms. Remember, these are the chemical substances which are derived from living cells and prevent the growth of microorganism. I think already you know one of the very important antibiotic, that is penicillin, which is derived from one of the fungi, Penicillium notatum. Remember, antibiotics, these are the drugs or chemical substances which are derived from living cells and prevent the growth of microorganisms. Best example, what is the best example? Penicillin is the best example. Next, another type of drug, that is analgesics. What are analgesics? I think you know, these are the chemical substances which reduce the body pain. There are two types. One is narcotic analgesics and another one non-narcotic analgesics. Okay, next one, antipyretics. What are the antipyretic drugs? Remember, antipyretic drugs are the chemical substances which reduce the body temperature. The chemical substance or drug which reduce the body temperature are called antipyretics. Best example for antipyretics are paracetamol as well as aspirin. Remember, these paracetamol and aspirin also act as a analgesics. Next, after this antipyretic drugs, another group of drugs, that is antihistamines. Remember friends, what are these antihistamines drugs? These are the drugs or chemical substance which reduce or which prevent the allergic actions. Antihistamines are the drugs which is used to prevent the allergic actions. I think best example for these antihistamines are cetirizine tablets. And you know, Benadryl. I think already you know about Benadryl. The chemical composition of this is diphenyl-hydramine. And another one, Jeet. I think you know about Jeet syrup as well as Benadryl syrup. Composition of it is chlorophenamine and Benadryl contains diphenyl-hydramine. Remember, these two are also act as a antihistamines. Next, after this antihistamines, plus another one, disinfectants. What are these disinfectants? Remember students, these are also the chemical substances which are kill the microorganisms. These directly kill the microorganisms. For washing doors, etc. these are very helpful. But remember, these disinfectants are not safe for living tissues. These disinfectants are not useful for living tissues. Next, another one, antiseptics. What are these antiseptics? These are also chemical substances. These are prevent the growth of microorganisms. Antiseptics also, they prevent the growth of microorganisms. Best example for antiseptic used in our day-to-day life is hydrogen peroxide and our Dettol. Different type of medicated soaps are used, comes under antiseptics. Next type of drugs is neurologically active drugs. What are these neurologically active drugs? These are the chemical substances which are used for the patients to control their emotional distress and depression. These drugs works on central nervous system, remember. In that, one type of drugs called tranquilizers. What are these tranquilizers, remember? These are the chemical substances which helps to the patient which are suffering from stress and depression. In that type of patients, these tranquilizers build confidence. Example for these tranquilizers are one of the medicine, Iproniazid and Equinil are the some examples for these tranquilizers. Usually these type of drugs build the confidence in presence of patients suffering from stress, etc. And another one type of drugs is that anti-fertility drugs. These are also a chemical substance which are used to control the pregnancy. What are anti-fertility drugs? These are the chemical substance which are used to control the pregnancy. Remember, some examples for anti-fertility drugs are Norethindrone, and another one, Novestrol. These two are the main examples for anti-fertility drugs. Next very important concept, artificial sweetening agents. What are these artificial sweetening agents? Remember, these artificial sweetening agents are also a chemical substance which gives more sweetness to the food. These type of chemical substance gives more sweetness to the food. Usually, these type of substances are very helpful to the patient suffering from diabetes. In that, some of the artificial sweetening agents are aspartame, saccharin, sucralose, and allicin. Remember, these are the artificial sweeteners when you compare with your cane sugar. This aspartame is 100 times more sweeter than the cane sugar. And saccharin, this is 550 times more sweeter than the saccharin. Next, another one, sucralose. This is 600 times more sweeter than the cane sugar. Remember, this is very important. Your allicin is one of the artificial sweetener. It is 2000 times more sweetener than the cane sugar. Remember, in this we are familiar with this artificial sweetener, that is saccharin. Remember, this saccharin is restricted for the cold foods because at high temperature our saccharin it becomes unstable. Remember, at high temperature this saccharin becomes unstable. Because of that point, it is used in presence of cold substances. This is about artificial sweeteners or artificial sweetening agents. Next, food preservatives. What are food preservatives? These are also a chemical substance which prevent the spoilage of nutritional value of the food. When you add these type of substances to the food, it increases the time of spoilage of the food. Best example for preservatives, food preservatives are NaCl, BHT, sodium benzoate, etc. Remember, NaCl, sodium chloride is best example for food preservative, and BHT means butylated hydroxyl toluene. It is also one of the food preservative. Next, sodium benzoate is also an example for food preservative. Next, soaps and detergents. Remember, soaps are the sodium or potassium salts of fatty acids. There are different types of soaps are observed. Example, medicated soaps. Next, another type, transparent soaps also appeared. Next, medicated soaps, bathing soaps, toilet soaps, etc. Usually the soaps are formed by one of the process, saponification. Remember. Next, another point about detergents. What are detergents? These are the surfactants or group of surfactants having cleaning properties with dilute solutions. These are the surfactants or group of surfactants having cleaning properties with the dilute solutions. Those are called detergents. In that detergents there are two types. One is cationic detergents, another one anionic detergents. In presence of anionic detergents, the cleaning agent is anion. In presence of cationic detergents, the cleaning agent is cation. Remember these points with some examples are very important in this chapter. Okay, remember these points. These are very helpful for the your CET examination as well as NEET examination. If you observe the previous question papers, the question is based on this concept only. Okay, some examples means some questions with answer we will see in next video. Thank you.